The diagnosis of antisynthetase syndrome can be a little difficult for someone to make. As I mentioned in the earlier video, patients present very differently. Some present with a lot of muscle involvement, some present with lung, some present with predominantly joint. So the clinician has to be very astute when evaluating the patient, and a lot of testing is often needed to solidify diagnosis. As I mentioned before, one of the most important things is knowing whether a patient makes one of those antibodies, the JO1, PL12, EJ, ones I mentioned in the earlier videos. However, not every patient makes an antibody. So when it's present, it's very helpful, but just because a patient does not have one does not mean they do not have this syndrome. So there was a lot of negatives in that term, in that phrase, but you can still have this syndrome even if you do not have an antibody. A lot of the testing we do for diagnosis gets back to how patients present. So as I mentioned before, muscles, lungs, and joints can all be affected. So a lot of the diagnostic testing focuses on those areas. So for the muscles, what we'll often do is ask for an MRI. Basically, it's an MRI that goes from the hips to the knees because those muscles are often affected in patients who have antisynthetase syndrome. And there are certain signals you can see on the MRI scan that are suggestive of having muscle involvement. Similarly, something called an EMG or nerve conduction study can also be done. This is when certain probes are put into the muscles themselves and you can get information there which can be useful. From the joint perspective, oftentimes that's evaluated by physical examination. So kind of feeling the joints, are they swollen, are they warm, do they look red, etc. And often other tests like x-rays will also be done to look at various joints. From a lung standpoint, a lot of things can be done, including a CT scan or a CAT scan of the lungs. And that basically just gives us a whole view of how the lungs look to see if there's any signs of fibrosis or interstitial lung disease. We also ask for pulmonary function testing. It's otherwise known as PFTs. And this is a test where patients are basically asked to breathe into a tube repeatedly. And from those maneuvers, we can actually measure and quantify certain things about their lungs. So all those tests that are done, and admittedly it can be quite a process to get them all done, are needed to get a full picture of how the patient is presenting, what organ systems are affected, and do they meet criteria to have antisynthetase syndrome.